Last fall, Snapchat said it was going to totally overhaul its app. The update's been coming out for a couple of months now, and a lot of people hate it. I mean, really, really hate it. But there's actually a lot to like here, especially for new users who are gonna have an easier time figuring out how to use Snapchat. So keep an open mind and follow these 6 tips for getting the most out of the new Snapchat. Tip 1, learn the layout. When you open the app, it still goes straight to the camera because Snapchat, above all, wants you to use this app to make stuff. But it's much simpler now. There's no more stories page, no super long feed of everything. Just swipe right from the camera and you get to your friends screen. This is where all your messages, all their stories, all your groups, everything lives. Or swipe the other way and you get to the discover page. This is where all the publishers and celebrities are. 3 pages. Camera in the middle, friends to the left, news and celebs to the right. Simple. Tip number 2, ditch some friends. Now that Snapchat's using an algorithm to decide what goes to the top of your friends list instead of showing them alphabetically, as soon as you have a few dozen friends, it gets really hard to find anybody. Just let them down easy, okay? You're gone, you're cool, you're gone, you're definitely gone. Tip number 3, find your friends. That screen with the list of stories is gone, but if you tap the circle and watch one person's story, at the end it'll automatically jump to the next person. You can tap that to watch it or swipe to the next. Tip number 4, tap carefully. The algorithm is monitoring everything you do, learning what you like and what you don't. In Discover, you can subscribe to stuff you like so it'll bump it up. But the algorithm never forgets, so best not to watch too much of Logan Paul or your ex, just in case. Tip number 5, protect your privacy. If you let them, people on Snapchat can see where you are through Snap Maps, and your stories can be lumped in with others to make things for Snapchat to share. If you like that, it's fun. If you don't like that, just open up settings, turn on ghost mode, and poof, you're gone. Tip number 6, this isn't Instagram. That's really the big thing here. Now that Instagram has taken all of Snapchat's best features and basically beaten it at its own game, Snapchat's intentionally gotten away from being a place where your friends mix with celebrities and all those influencers. On one side, it's just messaging, more like WhatsApp than Instagram. And on the other, think of it more like YouTube or Netflix, full of stuff to watch, but not really a social network anymore. Snapchat's a lot easier to understand now, and it's a lot less like Facebook or Instagram or Twitter, all of which you can keep using, by the way. This is something different. Some people might hate it, but I like it. At least it still makes me look pretty.